coming to you live at the Gamma Trade Show at the Peppermill Resort and Casino in Reno, Nevada, Twist Gaming. Now take it away, Matt.
Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome. This is Twist Gaming. I'm Matt, and we are live here at Gamma 2019, bringing you all the board game coverage all week long. And I am joined here with Alex from Gray Fox Games. Alex, how you doing?
Matt, I'm doing fantastic. How about yourself?
I am just swell. First up, though, how is Reno treating you? How's Gamma treating you?
Reno's treating me great. Gamma's treating me great. I will say, I didn't get any sleep last night because I'm across the hall from you guys, and the Twist party just goes on so late into the evening.
It does, you know.
Yeah, you guys got to keep it down. I got to sleep tonight. Anyway.
So you brought a handful of games to show off here.
Yes.
And I'm interested in the first one that's set up on the table right now. So let's just jump right into that. What is this game?
So this is a game called Feelings. Feelings, the game of emotions.
Okay.
Are you in touch with your emotional side today?
I guess I'm going to have to be.
All right. Fair enough. So this is from one of the co-designers of Dixit.
Okay.
And this is a game about matching emotions. Now, it certainly has a family-friendly look to it, but this one is also one that is, I can attest, a ton of fun with friends. And in fact, the game comes with three different decks for family, for friends, and for young people.
Oh, that's interesting.
So it can play at in a bunch of different levels. Plays up to 8 players. We have it set up here for just a 2-player. It's not really much as a 2-player game, but they kind of get a sense of the mechanics.
Right.
So the gist of this is, do you remember the old game show Match Game?
Oh, absolutely.
So this is a match game, but with shifting partners. So each round, there's going to be one person who's the master of emotions. So I'll be the master of emotions.
Okay.
This is the four friends deck, maybe a bit more of adult questions.
Gotcha.
Not adult. This is not an After Dark kind of
game. Right. PG-13 then.
Very much PG-13. For instance, a question like this. Any federal benefits will be suspended for anyone whose children have committed a criminal offense. What you're going to do is you're going to pick which of these 8 emotions best matches how you feel about that.
Huh.
So benefits will be suspended for anyone whose children have committed a criminal offense. Which of those 8 do you feel about? Don't tell me, but take one of those 8 cards that matches the numbers on the board and pick the emotion that best fits.
All right.
And don't show it to me. Put it face down in front of you.
Okay.
I'm going to pick one. I'm going to look at myself and I am going to say this is my pick.
All right.
So what's going to happen is there are now going to be cards to match you up with a partner. Mm-hmm. So we'll shuffle up those cards and deal them out to different partners. Let's say we got paired up. What we're going to do from there is I'm going to try and figure out how you felt about that.
Okay.
And you're going to try and guess how I felt about that. So I'm going to take a second card, and knowing the very little I know about Matt, let's see. He's a decent blackjack player.
I wouldn't go that far. But
well, okay. I'm going to put this as my guess.
All right.
I'm going to put that face down sideways
so
in front of me.
I'm trying to figure out yours.
You're
going to
guess for me.
Okay.
So, and to be clear, if you thought, and this is going to spoil a little bit, but if you thought I felt the same as you, there's one card in the deck right here.
I was going to
This card that has, I feel the same, like this person feels the same as me. There you go.
Gotcha.
That card right there. Notice I gave you the purple set. Very kind.
I think it fits quite nicely.
So then we go around the table and we'd say how we felt about it. So in my case, I was disappointed.
I was actually disappointed as well.
Oh, we felt the same.
But we didn't think we felt the same.
We didn't think that. So I thought you were going to be surprised.
Oh, see, I thought you were going to express some contempt for that.
So because we are not on the same page, no one gets any points.
Okay.
If one of us had matched, if I'd matched you or you matched me, we'd both get 1 point.
Okay.
And if we both matched each other, we were in perfect sync, we'd both get 3 points.
Oh, so it's a little added bonus then.
Exactly.
Gotcha.
A big added bonus,
yeah.
Because that's how you're scoring. A game can be played to 24 points or as many rounds as you feel is fun. But that's the gist of it. It could rotate around. You'll then swap out emotions. There's plenty of these emotion cards in the deck.
Okay.
That's how you play Feelings.
That's pretty straightforward.
Just that simple.
Straightforward. There's more emotions than this here. How many different emotions cards are we talking about?
Oh, man. You put me on the spot.
I know.
I'm going to have to count them out loud here. Ready? No, I'm not going to count them out loud, but I am going to dig through here. Let's see. Another one we could have had is irritation. We could have had joy. I think there's something somewhere close to 20, if I had to guess. Mistrust,
okay.
Resignation, fear, disgust, wonder, satisfaction, anger.
All right, so the game's not going to play the same way every single time because we've got a different bevy of emotions.
Correct, and different situations, too. For instance, one of the ones I could have picked on this card was, during a party, someone you know offers you cannabis. How do you feel about that? There you go. And there's a third one on here, too. So each of these cards comes with three different prompts. And as mentioned, they can play with families. They can play at schools. There's different decks meant for these different situations.
Gotcha.
Yeah.
I like the fact that they have the option to play three different styles there. If you're playing kids, with family, with, you know, the after hour, not after dark, after hours.
For, yeah, after hours. Yeah, there's a version in the works that might have more of the after dark kind of theme
gotcha.
Of this. But no, this is the family-friendly, fun for everyone kind of edition of this game.
Very cool.
So that's Felix. Coming out in Q2. Almost on the boat to get over here.
It's right around the corner.
Yep.
Is there a price point set on this one
yet? Yeah, so $34.99 MSRP.
Nice.
Yeah.
Okay. So next up, we've got... Which one are we doing?
I don't know. Do you want to feel something lighter? You want to go back to the, so this is from one of our imprints. This is from Social Sloth Games, which is meant to be more of the lighter, more family friendly, more casual kinds of games.
All right.
We have another one from that line. Which are you a big fan of Telestrations?
Yeah, I am.
Okay, you might like this twist on this. So this is a prototype
twist,
box.
Twist. I like what you did there. Yeah.
I'm right with it. So this is a prototype box, so excuse the appearance a little bit, but the game itself is a ton of fun. This is a game called Draw Your Own Conclusions.
Okay.
And how Draw Your Own Conclusions works is it's similar to Telestrations in that you have a clue that you're trying to get someone else to guess.
Right.
Let's say we were all sitting around a table. Mm-hmm. I'm going to have a prompt on here, so I might say have javelin throwing or pipe smoking or push-ups. And I have to... along with the other people at the table,
right.
Try and draw it in such a way that you can figure it out. So far, so similar to Telestrations.
Right.
There's not that exchange between word and image, but somewhat similar enough.
I gotcha.
The twist on this is everyone has a shape in front of them. So triangles, squares, moons, and you can show those to the folks if you want. I don't know if those will come across. Circles, L's, teardrops. Everyone has that card and only that card in front of them.
Okay.
So let's say under here we had... Let's just say javelin throwing is the answer. I'll write that in there secretly.
Not so secretly.
Not so secretly in this situation, yeah. But typically secretly. And it would ultimately be you who would have to guess it.
Okay.
And then off of this card, let's say it was javelin throwing, and I have squares. I can draw no more than 5 squares to try and start communicating what that idea is. And then after that, the next person has only triangles to work with, no more than 5 triangles. And the next person has teardrops and then L's.
Oh.
And somehow using those shapes together, we can come up with an image. So
you could only draw
I can
those
only
shapes.
Draw squares and no more than 5 of them.
Oh, wow.
So you have to work with everyone else at the table to kind of build an image.
Ooh.
I'll show a good example on the back here. Ah! Apologies for the prototype box, but there you go. So, for instance, this person had squigglies. This person had moons. This person had circles, and sure enough, you put those all together, you might get a genie.
Huh.
Or you might get something that doesn't even remotely resemble a genie.
I imagine you get some kind of ridiculous shapes sometimes.
I am terrible at this game. I am so very, very, very bad. The first guess that you get after this is a free guess, completely free guess. If you get it wrong, then you can pick any one shape and ask the person who drew it, what was that shape signifying? So on this one, for instance, if I pointed to this squiggly line, what is that? They get a one-word answer. They could say
smoke.
Exactly right. Or I. And hopefully that's enough to get that across. The fewer clues you need to get everyone to get theirs correctly, the better your score, the better you do. That's Draw Your Own Conclusions.
Very cool.
Yeah.
So Draw Your Own Conclusions, we're expecting this on the shelves when?
This is going to be a little bit later on this year, probably closer to Q3, mm-hmm. maybe even Q4. It's just now getting to the printer, so... but we're excited about this. This one was done by Jay Cormier from the Bamboozle Brothers fame. Decent designer and a game that, despite me being terrible at it, had an absolute ton of fun with. Yeah.
So party game, we're talking how many players here?
Game can play up to seven or eight players.
Plays better with more people.
It does play better. To a degree, it plays better with more people. It's sort of like a game like Just One. Have you played Just One?
I haven't.
Okay. Just One's another one of those where you have some amount of hidden information trying to communicate it. You have too many people in that, right? That's too much information gotten across. I will say with this one, discretion can be the better part of valor, and when you have fewer players, it forces you sometimes to use a square where a square doesn't belong.
I gotcha.
So, yeah.
Time on the game?
Time on the game is about 15 to 20 minutes.
Oh, so it's a quickie then.
Very quick game.
Cool.
Yep. So what's interesting is everyone has that sheet in front of them. So you're just passing to the left, draw past the left, draw past the left.
Right.
So you're basically playing 5 of those mini games in one at the same time since it plays simultaneously. Yeah.
Neat.
So it's Draw Your Own Conclusions. Cooperative doodling game.
Cooperative doodling.
Cooperative doodling. And the last one I have for you is one that some folks who were paying attention to Kickstarter are going to be more aware of. This is a game called War of the Worlds,
Ooh.
The New Wave. So, just like in War of the Worlds, it's a battle of aliens versus humans. This is set about 20, 30 years after the events of the novel. And the aliens are back. And this time they have beefed up their immunities. They're not going to go down with a simple virus. And now they are coming to wipe out the population of Great Britain. So this is the map. It's a two-player asymmetric game. So one player is trying to play as the aliens.
Okay.
One player is playing as the humans. The humans' objective is to deal 30 points of damage to alien forces, whether that be buildings, or that be UFOs, or that be tripods. And the humans' objective, or sorry, the aliens' objective, is to wipe out the entire population of Great Britain, as represented by these wonderful cubes.
Mm-hmm.
So you'd fill out the board.
Right, right.
This would come with standees. This is, again, a prototype, so...
I love the look of the board. It's I like the graphic design. It's really pretty.
Yeah, it kind of evokes a sense of that novel.
Right.
And that kind of old-timey Britain. There's a nasty little tripod here up to no good. Let's see. We also have tanks for the humans, battleships, boop. And, of course, would not be an alien game without a UFO. So this is a two-player asymmetric deck builder. So you're each going to start off with unique decks. So these are all of the human cards, and these are all of the alien cards.
Okay.
And the alien cards will have things like this tripod. So you'll notice on this card it has several options. So you can either move one tripod unit to an adjacent land region. So if I had my tripod out here on the board, I could move it from here at the UFO crash site to this next spot over.
Okay.
Or the second option on that card is to do two damage in a region with a tripod unit. So if this one happened to be in this zone, I could destroy two of these human cubes.
Gotcha.
Just as such. Or the third option, if I'm really getting desperate, is I can remove this card from the game, that's that bottom row, in a region with a tripod unit, and wipe off and do three damage. Now, that damage can be to humans, but it can also be to army units or navy units, or it can be to buildings. Because, of course, the humans want to fight back. Humans have cards like gorillas, where they can use their forces. Just a little bit of see-through there.
Just a bit.
Can do damage directly to alien forces, so one of these civilian tokens can fight back. But the bigger factors are things like tanks and also, let me find a good building here, things like this tank factory or the bunkers or the fort, which can give you extra defense and you can hide your humans in that section.
Mm-hmm.
The way these games typically play out is the aliens tend to come out pretty aggressive, but then as the humans retreat and scramble and build up their forces,
they ramp up,
they're able to fight back. And it usually ends up being a pretty close call down the stretch.
Very cool.
Yeah. So just a decently simple deck-building mechanic, but done in an asymmetric fashion where you're working against each other in really interesting ways. And if you have any love for that theme...
And a little bit of dudes on the map, too.
Of course, a little bit of a dudes on a map. Yeah, it's combining. It's mixing and matching those two well-loved types of games.
But very cool that it's War of the Worlds themed as well, you know?
Yeah.
Very cool. So this is available, you said, at Kickstarter.
So this one was on Kickstarter earlier this year. We're expecting this probably to be closer to a Gen Con release.
Okay, perfect.
Yeah.
And price point on this one is?
Price point on this one is $39.99.
Oh, nice.
Yeah.
Very cool.
Yeah.
So aside from the games that we showed off today,
yep.
War of the Worlds, as well as the other two, what else is coming on from Grey Fox Games that you wanted to talk about? If you can give me any behind-the-scenes information.
So this is not so behind-the-scenes, but there's a game called Champions of Midgard is the one that we're best known for.
Right.
And the sequel to that game was on Kickstarter late last year.
Mm-hmm.
We anticipate being able to release Reavers of Midgard, the sequel to that game, coming at Gen Con. That's more of a Euro-y flavor, a twist on Reavers. If you got into Champions and really had a strong love for that game, this is taking it in a little bit of a heavier direction,
mm-hmm.
a little bit more of a Euro-y feel, but still has that Champions flavor. You still have the Blame and still have the battles, the epic sea battles, and battling a worker. It uses a mechanic called single worker placement,
mm-hmm.
where you'll place one worker, I'll get the best possible version of that action, and then it gets worse and worse. And
gotcha.
Worse around the table. So everyone has one action to use each round
okay.
over the course of a six round game. Yep.
Very cool.
So that's Reavers of Midgard. And then the really big one coming next week to Kickstarter from us is a game called Tsukiyomi, Full Moon Down.
Tsukuyomi Full Moon Down.
Okay. Yeah,
so what's that game like?
So that game is a beefy area control game, I would say, set in a world where the moon has come crashing down into the Earth, and it's irradiated all of these different species on Earth, whether it be boars or evil bugs or whatever else, and it's an asymmetric faction game. So area control, you're trying to battle for control of the board, but of course these factions have different objectives. The Boar Lords have a different goal than, say, the Dark Seed. Yeah, that's their name.
Awesome.
And so that game was released as a standees game by a company called King Raccoon Games. Mm-hmm. We have a version that's going to be coming out with minis.
Ooh.
An epic game with minis. So
everybody likes minis.
Oh, and everyone's going to like these minis a lot. The art on this game was already gorgeous, and then to have those minis really bring it to life.
Just take it to the next level.
Incredibly excited about that one. So those are a couple of the highlights, yeah.
All right, so where can our viewers go to find more information about any of the games you showed off or talked about today?
Go to grayfoxgames.com. You can also find us on Facebook, Gray Fox Games, Twitter, at Gray Fox Games, or Instagram.
Sounds
at Gray
good.
Fox Games, yeah.
Alex, thank you so much.
Matt, thank you.
Really appreciate it. And thank all of you for watching at home. Stay tuned. We're going to be coming back to you with more coverage throughout the day here at Gamma 2019. But for now, signing off, I'm Matt. Have a good one, everyone.